Welcome back, and I'm talking to Dwayne Dardan. Dwayne is the street and landscape superintendent for the city of Roanoke.
Yep.
Thanks for joining me this morning. We want to talk about snow removal because, you know, that's coming up.
It is.
As it does every year. And I want you to tell our viewers a little bit about the process that you all go through to get ready. How do you prepare for snow?
Well, the biggest, obviously, we, like everybody else, watch the local news media to see when things are coming, watch the National Weather Service.
Right.
And we have a paid forecast service called Meteorologics.
Mm-hmm.
And from that, we can tell when there's snow equipment ready to be used, we go ahead and get that ready to go.
Uh-huh. And so do you, you get the plows, you put the plows on top of on the trucks, and
the spreaders on the trucks, that kind of thing. And then after that, we make determines about staffing as far as how many are going to report, when they might report. We use that paid weather service, Meteorologics.
Okay.
And they can help us pinpoint when the precipitation is going to arrive, the duration of the precipitation, and how much is going to accumulate on roadway surfaces.
Well, and a lot of people don't realize it has to have all that planning behind it. Just get the truck and go.
No, it's not that simple.
Not that simple. And so about how many trucks do you usually have going out?
It's typically about 50 plus or minus depending upon the event every and that's per shift. So we have two shifts, 12-hour shifts, start 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. and 7 p.m. to 7 a.m.
So it's around the clock. It's not
around the clock. That lets us go 24/7. Back in January, we actually had an event where we went 17 straight days of 24/7.
So, wow.
Yep.
Well, and something new this year is the snow plows have been decorated. Talk a little bit about how that happened.
We have behind us two plows, one from William Fleming High School and one from Fallon Park Elementary. And Fallon Park was the People's Choice Award winner, so they were at the Civic Center and folks voted and they were the ones who got a pizza party and some recognition.
So that, you had a little contest,
A little contest, that's right.
Thought it'd be nice just to kind of decorate the plows a little bit.
Yeah, yeah. Gets a little positive PR for the schools. They did a great job. The students did a wonderful job. And they're so excited. They love doing that kind of stuff. So
once you're out there with snow plows, what are the priorities for clearing the roads?
Well, typically we do the arterials collectors. Those are the ones that carry the most traffic, obviously. And then we go to Valley Metro routes and residential routes.
And how can our citizens who are watching at home, how can they help you when you all are doing all this?
Three words.
Okay.
Parking, parking, parking. So you either park off the street if that's a possibility. If not, park on one side of the street.
Right.
If you have to park on both sides, park alternate.
Mm-hmm.
What we have is a problem where we've got narrow streets, 25 feet wide. You've got two cars parked next to each other.
Yes.
That's 7 feet wide a piece. That leaves 11 foot, and we've got a 10-foot snowplow.
Right.
And I know I don't want a snowplow within 6 inches of my vehicle, but that's what we end up with in a lot of situations.
Right. And so when that happens, it slows down the process
of
removing the snow.
And some streets we actually cannot get down
that
street without people moving their cars, and that just it's no good for anybody.
Okay.
So park off the street, or alternate or on one side of the street.
And there's also something people need to know about their sidewalks, snow getting, about that a little bit.
Well, they have to remove snow based upon the city code. City forces do the same thing at public buildings. We have city staff that goes and clears snow from the city sidewalks. Same thing.
Just a safety thing,
It's a safety thing,
Okay. Now, one more thing. A lot of times when there's a snow event, people don't know who to call if their electricity goes
out
or there's a water. Talk a little about what they
should
do.
If your power goes out, call the AEP 1-800 number,
me.
If it's another utility, call them directly. The city can't really do anything about other
utilities. Like the Water Authority.
That's right. Water Authority, call them directly.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Okay. And then for information about snow removal and what people need to do, how do they get that? What's the best way to find
out? Well, the best way to find out is actually call 211. They actually have snow removal information, what progress we've made. If the street needs to be cleared, they can call 211.
During the event.
During the event.
Okay.
If you want information between now and an event, call 853-2676.
Okay, well, we're ready. I know you guys are ready.
We are.
Hopefully we won't have that much snow this year, but thank you so much for sharing
Thank you, Melinda.
Okay, we'll be right back.